truth for life. September 10th, the priest we need. Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast our confession. Let us then, with confidence, draw near to the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Hebrews chapter 4, verses 14 through 16. The Old Testament underlines again and again the weight of responsibility on high priests in Israel. See, for example, Exodus chapter 29 and Leviticus chapter 16. Being the high priest was not to be taken lightly. Only he could enter the most holy place, the inner chamber of the Jewish temple. Only he could offer a blood sacrifice for the unintentional sins of the people. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 7. Although he was not without sin, he served as an advocate for his community before God. But as the writer of Hebrews shows us, there has been one great high priest, namely Jesus, who did what no other priest could do, and shouldered a responsibility the weight of which no other human could bear. Jesus did not go through a curtain into the most holy place in the Jerusalem temple. Instead, as God's Son, he passed through the heavens so that he now appears on our behalf before the Father's throne. We need not lament his physical absence on earth, not only because he is present with us through the Holy Spirit, but also because his absence means that even now he is directly speaking to God the Father on our behalf. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 25. That is why in the New Testament, ministry is not set apart for an order of priests who make blood sacrifices. Those who are called by God and given both the privilege and responsibility of leading and teaching God's people do not have to advocate before God for his people in the way the Old Testament priests did. Because our great high priest has offered up the one great sacrifice for sins, there is no need for any other advocate. Indeed, his priesthood leaves room for no other offerings for sin, either in heaven or on earth. He alone could die for us and speak for us, and he alone has done it. The very greatness of Christ's priesthood lies in the fact that he has offered himself for our sins once and for all. We need nothing more than to recognize that he holds his priesthood permanently because he continues forever. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 24. Jesus alone is able to save those of us who come to God on the basis of his merits. He always lives to intercede for his people. He is doing so right at this very moment for you, so you can live confident of access to the heavenly throne room whenever you pray, and access for your soul on the day you die. Today, all you need to do is hold fast to your confession of faith in the great high priest who has done all that is needed. Hebrews chapter 7, verses 23 through 28. The former priests were many in number because they were prevented by death from continuing in office, but he holds his priesthood permanently because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able to save to the uttermost those who draw near to God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. For such it was indeed fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, innocent, unstained, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. He has no need, like those high priests, to offer sacrifices daily, first for his own sins and then for those of the people, since he did this once for all when he offered up himself. For the law appoints men in their weakness as high priests, but the word of the oath, which came later than the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever.